Hey, hello everyone. So in this video I'm going to show you how to construct a class diagram for online examination system, and I'm going to do this entire task in StarUML. So let's get started. So first what you do is you need to open StarUML and go to model and go to add diagram, and you need to select class diagram. There will be a list of diagrams. You need to select class diagram, and by default all the shapes necessary for class diagram will be appearing. If it doesn't appear, you just go and select class diagram option. So here I would recommend you use at least 4 to 6 classes, because if you use only that much in classes, our diagram would look good. And if you use only less number of classes, that is 3, means our diagram would look incomplete or blank. So I would suggest you to use 4 to 6 classes, and let's get started. So just select the class and press it over here and just rename it. Our first class is going to be the person who is going to use our online system. That is in here, it's going to be the students, because students are going to take the exam. Okay. So it's going to be student class. Okay, just expand it and double click over here to add the attributes. You'll be having this inclined rectangle icon, so just click it to add an attribute. So first attribute, as you know, it's going to be name, ID, mobile, email, that stuff. So it's going to be name. So this is of the type string. Okay, name, roll number or register number. Roll number is going to be of type integer. Don't put float over there, because no roll numbers will be in the form of decimals. So be careful, just put integer. Keep it simple. Name, and next one is going to be mobile number. Mobile number, which is also of the type integer. Email ID, which is also going to be of the type string. And next one is going to be the school or college name. You can put anyone, whichever you want. I'm just showing you as an example. That's it. You can also add address and password. Okay, so next thing, we are going to add the all the operation what a student can perform. Okay, so just double click it again. You'll be having the settings like option, just click it. So the first option for student will be login. Before login, register. Okay, register, because what in my system, the student first register first. So register, then login. Just imagine as if you're doing, so you can get, like, it'll be easy to get all the attributes and the operations in your mind. Just personify as if you're doing. So login and edit details. Okay, all the details, the student can edit their profile, edit details, and take tests. Okay, exam, in case of any exam, because students can take the exam. And view result. Okay, view results and log out, basically. So this is how, that's the main functions, I guess, for in case of like any options. That's it. You know, this is well and good, because we have done with 5 attributes and 6 operations, so that's fine. This is fine for the student class. Our next class is going to be the test itself, our examination. So just enlarge it, and you just type it as exam. So before, like, you are going to like do any online test, you will be having a brief description about the online test. That is the name of the test, the number of that number, that unique ID of the test. Every test will have ID, like if there are multiple tests in that particular site, and the number of questions in the test, total number of marks, whether it is negative marking or not, the instructions of the test, and you have a start time and end time as well as there. So that will be like a particular page. So that is what corresponds to this exam class. So this will have only attributes, no functions. Okay, just attributes. Just start test, maybe you can put for as an operation, that's not needed. So just go to exam and just type exam name of the type string, and exam number of the type integer. Next one is going to be the instructions. Okay, instructions. That is going to be of the type string as well, and you have that mark split up. Okay, mark split up, like each part will have, each section will have each mark. Okay, so part A will have, like, will be the MCQs, part B will be having like the attribute kind of stuff, so that will have like higher marks than the verbal one, than the English verbal question. So each section will basically have like separate allocated marks. So marks split up. Okay, split up, that is going to be a false or type integer. And negative, in case of any negative marking, that marks split up will clearly inform us in case of like any negative marking. and duration of the test. Okay, duration, how long the test is going to go. So duration, that's going to be of the type integer. So that's fine. This is for good for our exam class. For next class, let's go to next class. Just hit it and paste it over here. So next class is going to be the question class. Okay, test question, we can name it as. So this basically contains the format, how the question is being applied. Okay, so test question, so whether it is a multiple choice or a paragraph type, so that's it. So this also won't have any operations, only attributes. Okay, so just click it and click the attributes. Okay, so each question will have the question number. Okay, question number, which is of the type integer, and mark. Okay, each question will have its own mark, integer, that is also of type integer, and question type. Okay, so whether it's like a paragraph question or it's like a multiple choice question, or you need to like write a essay over there, so it's going to be question type. So question type is basically, I would choose string because it's like a description. Okay, that's what the question type is. And if it's on like any MCQs, MCQ option, in case of any MCQ, it's going to be MCQ options. Basically just put options. Okay, question options, like, so options is also going to be of a type string. That's fine. This is for the test questions class. Okay, next class is going to be like a person who is going to control all the stuff. Okay, from the back end. So he or she is going to be like the admin of the this online exam system. So it's going to be like the, I'll just name him as exam admin. Okay, so he or she is the person who is going to like add the students who are eligible, like allow them to attend the exam, set the duration, set the question paper. Not set, but through him, like, we can control the system, like a back-end person who operates the system. So let's just go and add the attribute. Same stuff, name, it's going to be of a type string, and ID is also going to be of type integer. Password, you can add password. Phone number is going to be of type integer, and email ID of the type string. That's it. So now let's go to the functions. Okay, so just click it. So the first function is going to be edit tests. Okay, so this basically includes all the editing all the questions, and basically adding all the questions and changing the marks according to the each subject. So this is basically the edit test. And next one is like, next operation is going to be like edit users. So in case like any student has like completed this schooling or college, that person need not be like registered to site. Basically the admin can just delete them, so that they occupy unnecessary space, like their details occupy unnecessary space in the database. So you can basically delete all them, all their details and all their stuff from their particular site, because they aren't used, are no longer going to use that particular site. So edit users. And next one is like calculate the marks. Okay, calculate marks in case of like total, not going to calculate, like extracting the marks for each subject and publishing the results. So also can add publish results. These are like the main functions of the exam admin. And let's go to our another class. Okay, result will be the like another class. Okay, results, we can name it as results. It's fine. So this is going to have like attribute. Just imagine result as like a mark sheet that you get at the end. So what are the stuff the mark sheet will have? It will have a name. It is a student name, that is of the type string. ID, other type integer. ID will be like different from register number. Okay, register number is confined to a particular institute. Okay, ID will be like overall in the national level. So register number is of the type integer. Name, and you will also have your school name, string, your class, etc., mobile number, email ID, like email will be there, school name will be there. That's it, I guess. These are what will come in your mark sheet. School name, class name will come, your school name will come. And another next important thing is like your mark, okay, result mark, I forgot mark, mark is going to be of type integer and your grades for each subject. So it's going to be grades, and you see a pastor file that A grade, O grade, A plus. So it's going to be of type character data type, because where you're going to have only A, it can't be a string, okay, don't put string there. Grade should be of only character data type, char data type. So that's it for our results. And next, the final thing is going to be the teacher, okay, teacher or the person who is going to, professor who prepares the question, okay. Let us put teacher over there. Not, it's not going to be an issue. So the work of like a teacher is going to be like prepare the questions. That's it. The teacher is going to prepare the question, pass it to the system admin. The system admin is going to like update the question in the exam portal, in the online exam portal. That's what is going to happen. So let the teacher have like a name and ID, that's fine. String of the string data type, and ID is going to be of the type integer, and that's it. And the operations are going to be prepare question, okay, prepare question paper, evaluate results. Plus, after getting the results, the teacher needs to like evaluate the results only, okay. Even though it's like online, the teacher can like assess each person based on their performance. So this teacher has all the rights to evaluate the results, and teacher has also rights to declare the results, okay. So in case anyone can declare the results. So I think that's it. These are like perfect for our online examination system. Now let me just regroup everything in a fine way. System admin results will be here, okay. So let's go with the data associations. The student will take the exam, and the exam will in turn have all the test questions. Okay, the exam admin will ready all the exam, and okay, we'll all publish it, and the teacher will like give the question paper to the exam admin, okay, and the student will get the result. Well, that is published by our exam admin. So I hope it makes sense, this class diagram. You can just rearrange according to you. It looks shabby over here, so you can just rearrange it. Basically, like who has control over whom will be like the thing over here. The teacher gives the question, questions to exam admin like controls the question paper, publishes the result. The result goes to the student can only take part in the exam. That's it. So that's it for this video. And I also done many other class diagram like online shopping system, railway reservation system, and also many other use case diagrams and activity diagrams by using StarUML. You can just check those videos also. And mine is actually a programming channel. I've done tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Blender, that is 3D animation, and Unity. So do check other videos of my channel, subscribe and support me, and thanks for watching.